Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Anupam here and today we'll discuss how to declare brain dead, how to determine a brain death. And at the end of this class, I'll provide all of you with an algorithm that will be very easy and easy to remember so that you can apply in your day-to-day life, in your clinical practice. Let us discuss. So to decide brain death for a patient, the number one will be rule in. This is the first step. So you have to have a process inside the brain that has caused irreversible brain damage. And that can be done by doing a CT scan of brain, whereby you can find lot of pathology. For example, you can find subarachnoid hemorrhage, traumatic brain injury, intracranial hemorrhage, intraventricular hemorrhage, or anything else. Or you may suspect patient is having some kind of meningitis or meningoencephalitis with irreversible brain damage. In those situations, you may have to do a CSF study to look for infection. However, you have to remember that the caveat is, for example, patient who are having hypoxic brain damage or patient of drowning, the early CT may be inconclusive. So in those situations, what you have to do is repeat CT at 24 hours, right? So first you have to rule in. Once you have ruled in, the next step will be rule out. What do you mean by rule out? So we have to rule out any process that can mimic a coma, that can mimic a brain damage. For example, we have to rule out number one, severe dyslipidemia attemia, most specifically sodium and phosphate, too high or too low. Secondly, no severe acid base disturbances, acid base problems. No endocrine abnormalities. For example, what are the endocrine abnormalities that can happen in this patient? That can mimic, that is myxedema coma, hyperosmolar state, or patient can have simple hypoglycemia. You have to be very careful. Right. Number four, there should not be hypotension. Systolic blood pressure should always be more than 100. Number five, whether patient has taken some drugs, in the drugs can be you have given them, or patient has taken some toxin, or you have given neuromuscular blocking agent. What to do in that situation? You have to wait for 4 to 5 half-lives. If you know the nature of the drug, or else if you do not know the nature of the drug, you may have to wait for 24 to 48 hours. This is in case you do not know the nature of the drug. Right. In case of we have given the patient a neuromuscular blocking agent, you can do a what you call as train of 4. That is done to rule out any residual neuromuscular weakness. Right. Number 6, patient can have snake venom inside. That you have to rule out from history, physical examination and everything else. Patient can be having GB syndrome. The most important will be hypothermia. Patients not be in hypothermia. What do you mean by that? By definition, should not be temperature, should not be less than 32 degrees centigrade. Right? This is one important concept you have to remember here. So first you have a rule in, then you have rule out. Now, even if you've done both of these things, you have to wait for at least 4 to 6 hours to perform a focus neurological examination, or that will be 24 hours in case of hypoxic brain damage. Or in case of drowning, etc. Right. After 4 to 6 hours, we can do one single focused neurological examination to diagnose brain death. So what are the examinations that we'll discuss now? So this is the first step. This is the second step. Now we're coming to the third, fourth, fifth step, right? So first you have to prove in that examination there is no brain function. Brain function is absent. That includes cortical, sensory plus motor. And second will be no brainstem function, and third will be no spontaneous respiration, right? So these three have to prove. And before going to details into it, let us draw a diagram, right? We have the cortex, then we have the RAS system, then we have the midbrain, we have the pons, then we have the medulla oblongata, right? This is the cortex, this is the reticular activating system, both of them decides the alertness and consciousness. Then we have midbrain, we have pons, we have medulla oblongata, then we have at the least respiratory. So the things happens here from a rostral to caudal direction. This is the rostral and happens towards the caudal direction. So a person who is brain dead, the first thing that will go is the cortex and the RAS system. Then gradually the brainstem will be involved. So this is called the brainstem. And here lies the cranial nerve nuclei and the pathways of different reflexes. So when we're testing for brain death, we have to sequentially prove that there is no brain function, that is the cortical function, the brainstem function, and you have to confirm it with the dysfunction of the respiratory center. So how you do that? So for the brain function, there are basically two. If the cortex and the RAS system is not working, that means patient is in coma. What do you mean by coma? That is unarousable, unresponsiveness. Right. Plus you have to prove that there is no motor function. How to prove for motor function? You press the nail bed or areas of cranial nerve distribution like the supraorbital ridge or the temporomandibular joint. You find there won't be any response in the limbs or in the body of the patient. So motor function will be absent. Right. Now once you have proved that there is no brain function, at least at the level of cortex and motor function, to go to the brainstem function examination. So here, as you can see the midbrain, we have to check for different reflexes. First reflex to go will be papillary reflex. This will be absent. Second will be doll's eye. This will be absent. Doll's eye also otherwise called as oculocephalic reflex. Then number three, cold calorie test will be negative. This is also called oculovestibular. Then we have corneal reflex absent. Then we have cough and gag absent. You must remember that the cough and gag reflex, the center lies in the middle of the placenta. So whenever these things are absent, we have to finally prove there is no spontaneous respiratory movement also. So this is the third stage here. So we have to prove that there is no spontaneous respiration. We have come to here. So we have to perform what is called an apnea test, right? The details of the apnea test we'll discuss in our next video, but for our discussion today, if apnea test is positive and it has to be done twice at a gap of 6 hours, then patient is brain dead, right? However, if apnea test cannot be done or indeterminate, in such situation you have to do what we call as ancillary test. We have basically four of them. Number one is cerebral angiography. Number two will be transcranial Doppler. Three will be cerebral scintigraphy. And number four will be electroencephalogram, right? So in this way, we have to approach, right? You can see the cortical and RAS function here, then sequentially the brainstem function here, then finally the respiration, right? So in this way, we have to approach how to declare a patient brain dead. So the beginning, first rule in any process that can cause irreversible brain damage. Once you've ruled in, then you have to rule out the confounding factors. These are called confounding factors. So once you've done with all these two parts, you have to wait for at least 4 to 6 hours. Or in case of hypoxic brain damage or drowning, you have to wait for 24 hours. Then single focused neurologic examination is enough to declare a patient brain dead, right? And then how to do that? We have seen this works from rostral to caudal, from the brain's cortical system to the medulla oblongata to the respiratory center. We'll go sequentially. First, we'll prove that the cortex and RAS is not working by proving that patient is in coma and there is no motor activity. Then we have to prove that there is no brainstem functions by looking at the reflexes. Papillary reflex, doll's eye, cold calorie test, corneal reflex and cough and gag reflexes. Once you have done with these things, the ultimate test will be the respiratory center. If it is not working, by doing an apnea test, if it is positive twice at 6 hour interval, then person is brain dead. However, if the apnea test is indeterminate or cannot be done, you have to do some ancillary test. There are four types: cerebral angiography, transcranial Doppler, cerebral scintigraphy and electroencephalogram, right? So in this way, we approach how to determine brain death of a patient. Thank you very much.